Welcome to UT Southwestern's What to Know. Living with COVID-19 the past 8 months has produced many pain points for all of us, figuratively and literally. Whether your makeshift office is a couch or table or bed, chances are you're sitting more than usual and in ways your body may not be used to. And for many of you, your options for regular exercise have changed. Here with ways to help us with these pandemic-induced aches and pains are two musculoskeletal specialists at UT Southwestern, Dr. Kavita Trivedi and Dr. Jay Shah. Thank you both for joining us. Dr. Trivedi, I'm seeing a lot of my own patients who are having musculoskeletal complaints that they've never had before, sometimes neck or back pain. Why do you think that's occurring, and is that what you're seeing in your practice?
It is what I'm seeing in my practice. I think there's a few reasons for that. One is that a lot of patients and the population have stopped going to their gyms because the gyms have closed. So the normal exercise program that they participate in to keep themselves healthy and keep their musculoskeletal issues at a minimal, they can't do anymore because the gyms have closed. I also have a lot of patients that I'm seeing because they were in some type of physical therapy program, but that had to stop because the PT place is closed. And the third thing I'm seeing is this enormous shift to working from home. There's some issues that come along with that that can also cause musculoskeletal issues.
And Dr. Shah, are you seeing similar things in your practice?
What I'm seeing is that shift in their exercise routine is causing people to exercise in ways that they're not normally used to. So people who would swim or run on a track or a treadmill are now running on pavement at home, or they're having to bike up and down hills. And so that's leading to musculoskeletal problems or issues that they are not used to and their body's not used to. And so those are the types of injuries that I'm seeing frequently.
Dr. Shah, what does the term musculoskeletal pain mean?
When you break down the word musculoskeletal, it is the system comprised of the muscles and the bones. The analogy I like to use is of a car. So the skeletal system, or your bones and joints, they make up the frame of the car. Your muscles are like the engine that make it go. And so the musculoskeletal system allows us, our bodies, to have structure and then also locomotion, so get us to move. Musculoskeletal pain could be from any disorder or any condition that causes issues in the structural support of our body, such as a fracture or a sprain or a strain, or in the muscles that allow our body to move. And that could be a strain of a muscle pull, or a tendon injury.
Dr. Trivedi, a lot of people are setting up home offices. And tell us about the precautions that you would suggest to people and ways that they can prevent having some of the symptoms of neck and back pain that many patients are presenting with.
So the first thing I would say is when you're setting up a home work environment, find a dedicated spot for the workspace, and that is not your living room couch. Sitting on a couch with your laptop for 8 to 10 hours a day is not a good thing. So find an area, find a desk. The monitor needs to be at the right height. The top of the monitor should be at about your eye level. The monitor should be about an arm's length away from you. Maybe roll up a towel or a sweatshirt or something you have sitting around at home and put it between the chair and the small of your back to give you that extra lumbar support. The keyboard and the mouse should be so that your arms are not stretched out too far or too close to your body. If you use a phone a lot, try not to do this one of these cradling the phones between the shoulder. If you don't have a headset, use the speaker function on your phone. If you're able to get a standing desk, that is always a good thing because then you have the flexibility to raise it up, stand for a while, and then you can always bring it back down and sit for a little while too. But just changing that position intermittently throughout the day is also beneficial.
Dr. Trivedi, are you hearing similar complaints or hearing of symptoms in children and adolescents as well?
Absolutely. There's two reasons for that. One is the incredible rise of technology and the use of mobile devices. And that we have found has been leading to some musculoskeletal issues in kids and adolescents. With the pandemic, they're also on a screen for school, which leads to its own issues. And that links back to how adults have to set up a workstation at home with the right computer setup. The same thing applies to children.
Dr. Shah, many people are working the whole day virtually. Give us some advice on how they can be active during a virtual workday.
The key is going to be getting innovative, trying to find new ways to make yourself move. So if that be putting some of your workday upstairs and going up and downstairs, or finding a desk where that you can, that allows you to stand. There's some other technology out there. There's desks that have treadmills that are attached to them, or desks that you can put on top of an already existing treadmill. These are all ways to kind of get active while working from home.
Dr. Trivedi, when people are beginning new exercises, everybody sometimes is a little sore or feels a little differently as they start. What kind of symptoms should they be looking out for, and when should they see you for one of those symptoms?
Symptoms to look out for when you start a new exercise program that maybe you should be a little more concerned about are muscle soreness that doesn't resolve after a day or two, any type of sharp pain that you experience in any body part or joint that doesn't get better with rest and ice and kind of our normal treatments for sort of those acute type of muscle soreness activities. The other thing is significant increase in pain while you're doing something. Perhaps you did an activity that your body's just not ready for. And that is something that you should come and see a specialist for to make sure that there's nothing more serious going on.
And Dr. Shah, as people are beginning these new activities, how do you suggest they begin and what should they be looking out for?
I think know the activity that you're going into, right? So if you're going to change to a biking, know your bike types, know the wheel types, know your pavement types. And then the biggest thing is know your body and know how to increase your activity level slowly and gradually. I think the biggest thing is anybody can adapt to any type of exercise if it's given the right time and the proper attention.
Dr. Shah, you're an orthopedic surgeon. I know you've worked hard throughout the pandemic. What would you say to people or patients who are nervous about having surgery for an orthopedic problem during the current pandemic?
I can see where there's a lot of hesitancy and maybe fear regarding that, but the likelihood of transmission of COVID-19 within our own system is actually very, very low. Some of the internal studies and numbers have basically shown that it's safer to be at work than it is to be around our friends or family. The precautions that we have in place, are going to protect you and going to protect your providers and the surgeons and the entire team that's helping you get better.
Dr. Shah, throughout the pandemic, we've been worried about patients postponing care and actually getting sicker and disadvantaging themselves in terms of their own health. Have you seen that with orthopedic injuries? And is there a penalty for a delay in postponing good orthopedic care?
The longer you wait to get your orthopedic issue taken care of, the more you risk further injury or the injury becoming such that the repair is not as easy or the recovery is going to be even longer. It is paramount that you get your issues, your musculoskeletal issues, your orthopedic injuries looked at and taken care of in a timely manner.
Dr. Trivedi, tell us a little bit about how you're keeping you and your family safe while remaining active during the pandemic.
One of the biggest thing that we all did is we all got mountain bikes and have discovered biking trails and different things around the Dallas area that Dallas has to offer. I've lived here for over 10 years and didn't know how many biking trails and things like that that Dallas had to offer. So we can stay healthy, kind of bond, exercise, and stay safe and active.
Thank you both for joining us for all the great advice about how to be healthy while we're staying active.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. Until next week, stay safe and stay healthy.